This afternoon, hundreds of people were due to gather at Belfast Cathedral for the 999 Festival of Thanksgiving to pay tribute to the 2 million men and women who serve across the emergency services. As with countless other events across the globe, this year's 999 Festival was cancelled due to the coronavirus. We have, however, put on a special online programme with guests, including a special message from His Royal Highness the Duke of Cambridge. Welcome to a special version of the Emergency Services Festival of Thanksgiving 2020. Today, I should have been making this speech in Belfast Cathedral, and looking out before my eyes would have been hundreds of people from across the emergency services, from all four corners of our United Kingdom, gathered in the magnificent cathedral to show our united appreciation for our NHS and 999 heroes. Instead, The world is in the midst of a health pandemic, the likes of which are unprecedented. So far, over 200 serving emergency services personnel have lost their lives in the course of their duties whilst trying to keep us all safe. During this pandemic, we have seen deep pain and sadness, which has touched almost every member of the emergency services family. At the same time, we have seen the very best of the NHS and emergency services. We have seen staff and volunteers going above and beyond, putting others first, and all whilst continuing to perform their other duties of fighting fires, policing the streets, and saving lives. That is an emergency services I am proud of. I would like to start by thanking the 909 Festival's committed trustees and ambassadors, and every participant in this special online programme. I am very pleased that we have the superb Blue Light Choir singing as part of this programme. We are immensely honoured that His Royal Highness the Duke of Cambridge, the First Ministers of Scotland, Northern Ireland and Wales, and the Home and Health Secretaries have recorded special online messages for this programme. Whilst my team and I are sad to have had to cancel this year's 909 Festival in Belfast, we simply could not let this year go by without honouring our 909 heroes. I have advised the First and Deputy First Ministers of Northern Ireland of my commitment to hosting the 909 Festival and the main 909 Day event in Belfast next year. This means we will now be going to Wales in 2022. I would like to give my appreciation to the Dean of Belfast Cathedral, Stephen Ford, and to the Government and Emergency Services of Northern Ireland for their support in the preparation for what would have been two incredible events in a great city. As I mentioned in my speech at the 909 Festival in St Giles Cathedral last year, the 909 Cenotaph, the 909 Festival, and the 999 Day all have their roots sown in tragedy. My grandfather John Scholes was a police officer in Greater Manchester Police. In 2001, one of his officers, a young 29-year-old policewoman, was tragically killed in the line of duty when she was run over by a stolen vehicle. The officers at their station planted a tree in her memory. My grandfather showed me the tree and said, "In this country, we don't look after our emergency services as much as we should." Those words have always stuck with me. Today, I would like to update you on the progress of the United Kingdom's first national 999 Cenotaph. In the coming months, we will announce the location of this important monument, which will be in central London. I am working with the Cenotaph sculptor, Philip Jackson, and the four governments in the UK to work out a plan to safely transport the maquette on a tour across the UK so that our 999 heroes can see it. I want to make clear the 999 Cenotaph is not intended to overtake individual service monuments. The Cenotaph is intended to promote the increasing amount of work carried out jointly by the emergency services when responding to the needs of the public. My vision is for the 999 Cenotaph to complement existing monuments. The monument, when built, will be a national symbol of the gratitude, sacrifice, and remembrance for our NHS and emergency services. It will also honour the role animals play in the emergency services, which is why the design includes a search and rescue spaniel. I shall now move on to updating you about the 999 day. It is testament to the spirit of the UK that the Emergency Services Day, which takes place on the 9th of September each year, has grown so significantly since I founded it a few years ago. It is humbling that last year's 999 Day saw support from Her Majesty the Queen and Their Royal Highnesses the Prince of Wales, Duchess of Cornwall and Duke of Cambridge. The 999 Day is your opportunity to show your support for our NHS and emergency services. It is intended to promote the wonderful work being done by the emergency services and to enable 999 charities to fundraise and promote their profile. As we saw earlier this year, people stood at their front doors and clapped for our 999 heroes. In villages, towns, and cities across these islands, we stand united in our unwavering support for those who put others before themselves. Ask any member of the emergency services whether they are a hero and they will tell you no, but they are. And without the almost 2 million people who work in the NHS and emergency services, a great many families would be engulfed by grief and pain. Next year, we will have this service in Belfast Cathedral. But let us remember the sacrifices made and work together to send a united message that this country is immensely proud and supports each and every member of the emergency services, whether they are paid or unpaid, first responder or administrative staff. To conclude, whether you ask police officers in Manchester, firefighters in Belfast, NHS and ambulance personnel in Swansea, or search and rescue and Coast Guard personnel in Aberdeen, all are proud to serve and do their bit. I truly believe we have the greatest emergency services in the world, and that is because the men and women who serve go above and beyond. It is now my pleasure to introduce in the video that follows His Royal Highness the Duke of Cambridge, a great supporter of the emergency services. Having served in the emergency services himself as an air ambulance pilot, Prince William knows firsthand the challenges and sacrifices 999 personnel make to keep us all safe. His Royal Highness has been doing some truly incredible work to promote mental well-being and collaboration across the emergency services, and I commit the complete support of the 999 Cenotaph, 999 Festival, and 999 Day to promoting that work.
At one point or another, each and every one of us will benefit from the care and protection provided by our emergency services. Their courage and selfless dedication to their work is something that this country is rightly very proud of. This year, more than ever, we have been repeatedly reminded of the sacrifices made by all those in the emergency responder community as they worked tirelessly to protect us against COVID-19 and keep the country going in the most challenging circumstances. Having had the privilege of working alongside emergency responders, I've always been struck by their remarkable can-do attitude in the face of even the gravest of emergencies. They showcase the very best that our country has to offer, and this is never more apparent than at times like these. Tragically, some will pay the ultimate price as a result of their efforts in the line of duty, while others will experience lasting effects on their physical health or mental well-being. We all have a responsibility to do what we can to support this community and to remember their efforts to keep us safe, as well as the many sacrifices made by both them and their families, which is why today's service is so important. On behalf of my family, I want to thank you all. Your hard work, your determination, and your courage are a tremendous source of pride for our country, and we will be forever grateful for all that you do.
On this special day, as we recognise the tireless work of all our emergency service team, I wanted to take this chance to thank you personally and on behalf of the whole country for your dedication and your sense of duty. The men and women of our emergency services are always there at our moments of greatest need, selflessly placing themselves in harm's way to help us all. So I'm very proud to be involved in this year's 999 Festival and give my wider support to the National Emergency Services Memorial and the upcoming 999 Day. I know that most of you see yourselves as ordinary people who are just doing their job. And whenever I talk to people who work in the emergency services, that is the overriding thing that people say. But our emergency services are made up of extraordinary people who do the extraordinary on a daily basis. And alongside you, our incredible NHS and our social care staff have also been on the front line of the fight against coronavirus, this dreadful disease, and our entire nation is rightly proud of you. This has never been more true than during the difficult times we've been through over recent months. You may not see yourselves as heroes, but you certainly are. And I want to reiterate our thanks for all the incredible emergency service workers today. You keep us safe, protect us, and have been at the forefront of helping us turn the battle against coronavirus. Thanks to you, we can now begin to return to our daily lives safely and securely. And finally, in particular, I want to pay tribute to those who've lost their lives in the line of duty, including during the pandemic. We must always remember and honour the courage of those who have laid down their own lives for us. Their sacrifice will never be forgotten, and the service of colleagues who've fallen will be recognised by the National Emergency Services Memorial, which will be a fantastic celebration of their achievements and commemoration. You've been there for us. You're there for us now in these most challenging of times, and we're forever grateful for that. Thank you.
I am pleased and proud to join with you and with people from right across the United Kingdom to say thank you to all of our blue light heroes. Every second of every day, our emergency services are there for each of us. From the person who takes the call to the first responders on the scene, these are highly skilled professionals who go above and beyond to save lives and protect us from harm. And as I know well, those who serve in our four emergency services of police, fire, ambulance and air, sea and mountain rescue are also our friends and our neighbours who are there to help each one of us in times of extreme need or peril. And so many are volunteers who step up for their communities selflessly every day. Over this last number of months, as we have combated a new risk to life, we have seen our emergency services take on this task like no other. They have faced up to this challenge and provide a response that is exemplary and world class. And I do want to take a moment to recall all of those who have lost their lives as a result of their service. They have made the ultimate sacrifice, and we will never forget them. The 999 Festival of Thanksgiving helps us to remember in gratitude the contribution of all those in our emergency services, past and present, and also to applaud their incredible achievements. This year, of course, we had looked forward to hosting this prestigious event at Belfast Cathedral for the first time. But as with so many other things, this has not proved possible. But I am delighted that we are still able to come together in this online celebration. We are united in thanksgiving. It is an honour to offer the heartfelt thanks of all the people of Northern Ireland to all of our 999 heroes. And we look forward to offering you a warm welcome in 2021.
I'm honoured to take part in the 999 Festival of Thanksgiving. In recent months, we've been reminded of the extraordinary contribution of our emergency services. They've been at the forefront of our country's response to the COVID pandemic. In addition, here in Scotland, our emergency services have had to respond to two major incidents, the knife attack in Glasgow and the train derailment in Stonehaven, and they have done an outstanding job. Of course, it's not just at times of crisis that we depend on our emergency services. Each and every day, people working in these services help to ensure our safety. They provide urgent care, support and treatment to those who need it. And often, by putting themselves in danger, they help to save lives. It's absolutely right that we reflect on that contribution and honour that sacrifice. That's why this event is so important. It's an opportunity to show our appreciation for the commitment and compassion of emergency service members. And it allows us to honour all those who have lost their lives in the course of duty. So I want to thank everyone taking part. I want to thank the National Emergency Services Memorial for organising today's event. And most of all, I want to thank from the bottom of my heart our emergency services for the extraordinary work they do every single day. It is hugely appreciated by all of us.
It's a pleasure to have the opportunity to mark the 999 Festival of Thanksgiving. At the start of this year, our emergency services were responding to unprecedented flooding as Storm Ciara and Dennis brought widespread destruction to so many parts of Wales. Then in March, in the grip of the pandemic, the majority of Wales came to a full stop. And while most could only play their part by staying at home, our emergency services continued their long and proud tradition of reacting and working swiftly, effectively, and above all, selflessly in terms of crisis. In the most unprecedented of circumstances, they have shown a professionalism, bravery, and adaptability that makes us all proud. In Wales, we've had firefighters standing ready to drive ambulances. We've had police and PCSOs supporting the vulnerable. PCSOs such as Iona Beckman and Neris Williams worked with the local food bank in Amlwch to deliver food parcels to local families in need. And PCSO Catherine McGonigal in Holyhead, working with youth services to create learning materials for vulnerable young people. In Haverford West, Abergavenny and Bangor, the local fire services deployed mass decontamination units to serve as temporary triage facilities. And of course, the police have been charged with supporting our efforts to keep Wales safe and to protect the NHS. We're right to be proud of the measured approach they have taken to police some of the most significant regulations we've ever had to enforce on people's lives in Wales. And I know that this cannot have been easy, turning visitors away during stay-down local rules and patiently explaining to people crossing borders that Wales has different rules in place. As visitors have returned in recent weeks, our volunteer rescue teams have been there on hand. And of course, under the most extreme pressure, our ambulance service and NHS emergency workers have put aside their own concerns to put patients at their ease. Even in these darkest of times, across emergency services, you have found strength in each other to lift the spirits of the communities you serve. As a nation, we try to express our gratitude. We put rainbows in our windows. We clap together on our doorsteps, but we know that it will never be enough. For your part has been to be there when people are at their most scared and vulnerable, when we all need someone else the most. It takes a real quality to be that person, to put the lives of complete strangers before your own. For this I know there are people right across Wales who will be forever grateful and incredibly proud of our emergency services. It's a privilege for me to pay tribute today on behalf of our country on this festival of Thanksgiving. O ran pawb yng Nghymru, diolch o galon I chi gyd.
The next video contains a wreath-laying ceremony. Participating are Ian Hopkins, Tom Scholes-Fogg, Martin Blunden, Michael Bloomfield, and David Simmons. That is followed by The Last Post, which is played by senior aircraftswoman Rachel Bodice. The Blue Light Choir will now sing Amazing Grace. The Emergency Services Prayer of Thanksgiving will now be read by Father Barry Lomax, who is chaplain to Greater Manchester Police.
The Emergency Services Prayer of Thanksgiving. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you for the selfless men and women of the emergency services. We thank you for all the resources you provide for their task, and especially for the animals trained to work alongside them. We rejoice in all who work for peace and the saving of lives in danger. We pray for those who serve in the emergency services, that you protect those whose service is our protection. May they ever receive your strength in the performance of their duty. We hold up to you those who have served in past years. We recall those who have paid the ultimate price in their task of preserving life and of upholding law and order. May all who serve or have served within the emergency service be embraced within your love, both now and forever. Grant that our nation may ever continue to show its gratitude towards those who serve within its emergency services, and not take for granted the precious work undertaken. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The next videos contain messages from Martin Hewitt, Chair of the National Police Chiefs Council, Roy Wilshire, Chair of the National Fire Chiefs Council, Darren Mockery, who is Chief Executive of the Association of Ambulance Chief Executives, and Claire Hughes, who is Director of Her Majesty's Coast Guard.
I think this is a really important year for us to give thanks to all of our emergency services who have played an enormous role in how the country is dealing with the COVID pandemic crisis. And particularly talking about policing, our service across the entire United Kingdom has carried on doing all its normal duties in relation to keeping the public safe, but has also done the additional work that we've done around helping to fight the transmission of COVID-19. And in all of that, we've worked with all of our partners in the other emergency services. So 2020 is a really important year for all of us to give thanks to all of those who are out there 24 hours a day, keeping our public safe.
I'm extremely honoured to be part of this year's online Festival of Thanksgiving. As we began 2020, few of us could have seen how the next few months would unfold, the COVID-19 pandemic taking hold globally. For emergency services across the country, it's been a tale of camaraderie, community, hard work, emotion, determination, and compassion, which is why this year's event is so important, to recognise all the hard work which has taken place and is still underway. Every single one of the 2 million people working and volunteering across our emergency services have played their part in the fight against coronavirus. Whilst working hard to maintain their normal services, whether it's firefighting, catching criminals, or treating illness. Like other emergency services, fire and rescue services continue to be ready, willing and able to do everything they can to help keep people safe during the pandemic. During lockdown, fire and rescue services continue to fulfil their protection, prevention and emergency response duties, as well as carrying out nationally agreed additional activities. These included delivering more than 100,000 essential items to the most vulnerable people in our communities. Fire and rescue services also worked alongside the National Health Service, care homes and police colleagues, driving ambulances, assembling thousands of face shields, fitting face masks for frontline staff, and sadly, on occasions, having to move bodies. We've also seen remarkably low absence rates across the Fire and Rescue Service, once again demonstrating the service's commitment and desire to help others. What we have achieved as a Fire and Rescue Service, however, forms just part of the COVID-19 emergency response. Together, we've stepped up, strengthened partnerships, and pulled together to take care of some of the most vulnerable people in our communities and therefore save lives. And for that, we should all be very proud. To each and every one of you, for your hard work and commitment, my heartfelt thanks.
As Chair of the Association of Ambulance Chief Executives and Chief Officer of the North West Ambulance Service, I would like to offer my sincere thanks to each and every one of our ambulance staff, volunteers and emergency service colleagues right across the UK for your public service and contribution to your local communities. The ambulance sector is privileged to work alongside our fantastic colleagues in health and social care, public sector organisations and the other emergency services. As I approach my 30th year in the ambulance sector and 32nd year in the NHS, I've never been as proud to work alongside and represent the thousands of staff and volunteers who make up the ambulance sector green family. So whichever emergency service you work within, whether it's frontline service delivery, support services, corporate services, or indeed volunteer as an ambulance community first responder, special constable, retained or volunteer firefighter, thank you. Thank you from me personally, and thank you on behalf of all the Ambulance Trust chief executives across the country for your truly amazing dedication, professionalism, and commitment to public service, and of course your response to the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. This has been the biggest challenge to face our NHS and whole country in recent times, and I'm incredibly proud of the way our emergency services have come together to support each other. Thank you.
it's absolutely pivotal that we are part of that emergency services family, and a really good example of that continual collaboration across that family was the recent Stonehaven rail incident, where all emergency services were present, including HM Coast Guard, to really work together to ensure that we could do absolutely the best for those individuals that were involved. But for me, it was all about collaboration. And that is a perfect example of how we came together as a community. I think also there have been other examples. We've had in the south of England a particularly busy, hot summer. We've seen unprecedented incident levels. And again, those incidents were all about working together with our emergency services family to get the right outcomes for those individuals that were in danger, needed advice, needed support. We were there together.
And that concludes this year's Emergency Services Festival of Thanksgiving. Thank you to all who have participated in this programme, and thank you to you for watching. Next year, we hope to be in Belfast Cathedral. Until then, stay safe, take care.
Lord, save our gracious Queen. Long live our noble Queen. God save the Queen. Send her victorious, happy and glorious. Long to